So sthana ikyat. Because the jiva and the paramatma both of them are one sthanam. Which is sthanam? That guha. So that guha or the cave of the intellect is where both jiva and paramatma is said to be. Therefore, they are one alone. So, nahi iti. Says Vashyakara. Nahi satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Yo veda nahitam guhayam. Iti kanchi deva. Ekam graham adhikritya. Etu duktam. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. That Brahman is satyam jnanam anantam. Satyam is truth. Nature of knowledge or intelligence. Anantam limitless. Yo veda nahitam guhayam. One knows that Brahman such is that which is abiding in the guha, in the cave. So sthana ikya. It is not that kanchideva guhayam adhikritya. That jiva obtains in one guha and Brahma obtains in another guha. So guha or a cave, yo veda nahitam guha, yo veda Brahma nahitam guhayam. So one knows Brahman as obtaining the guha or the cave. Don't think that the cave in which Brahman is realized is different from the cave in which jiva is the same cave. Sthana ikya. So sthanam parame parardhe chaya tapo, so parame parardhe. So that's the place of the abode. Parardha is abode of the Supreme Brahman, param. And so is one sthanam, one guha alone where the jiva and Brahma are said to be there, and there also they are one alone. Kanchideva ekamri jiva sthanat anyam. The jiva has one sthanam, one guha, and Brahma is another guha. It's not that there are two guhas. In one guha alone, both jiva and Brahma are said to be there, therefore both of them are one. Then says, Ratna Brahma, Nanu ekasyam guhayam do kim nasyatam. Alright, why not both jivatma and paramatma in the one cave? Why not? Ekasyam, you say that this guha that is referred to with jiva and Brahma is one alone. Now why not in one guha both of them can abide? That why not jiva and Brahma are two obtaining in one cave? So in Sarvayari said, Nachayati. Nacha brahmanaha anyaha guhayam nihitoste tat srishtva tadevanu pravishata ide srashtahu eva praveshashravana. Nacha, not again, brahmanaha anyaha guhayam nihitoste. Don't think that in the guha or the cave someone other than Brahman is actually abiding. Why do we say? Tas srishtva tadevanu pravishada. Upanishad very clearly says that having created the cave of the intellect, Brahman entered there. Tas srishtva tadevanu pravishada. That means that guha. Having created that cave, Brahman entered there. Iti srashtuhu eva praveshashravana. It is srashta, the creator of Brahma, who is actually delineated by Shruti. So Shruti says that he is the creator who enters the guha and not someone else. So Ratnavara, Sastu Eva Praveshena Jivatvat Navedaha. So the one who obtains the jiva is none other than Sastha, the creator. So creator has entered as jiva. Then say Ratnavara further, Nanum Atyanda Avede Jivasya spashta bhanat, brahmadi spashtam syat, ataha spashtatva aspashtatva bhyam, tayoho bheda viti chet. Very beautiful questions and answers are there to come to the ascertained knowledge. Vashyakara says the knowledge of oneness must be ascertained. So various doubts do arise based on experience that I see myself as a jiva, that's my experience. And sometimes Shruti also appears to say that. Therefore, there is a need to reconcile all this. Reconcile my experience of duality with the vision of Shruti that is non-dual. And reconcile certain statements of Shruti which also appear to be delineating duality, telling about duality. All that reconciliation is necessary, which what Brahma Sutra does. And Bhashyakara takes the opportunity to do that. It says, Nanu atyanta bhere If you say that Jiva and Brahma are absolutely one, Jiva is just Pashtabhana, but my experience is that the Jiva Atma is one who is very clearly experienced by me. Brahma Vispashtam Syat. If Jiva alone is Brahman, then Brahman also should be clearly experienced by me. If I am Brahma right now, then the Jiva is Brahma, then Jiva is experienced, Jiva is Ahankara, is experienced by me very clearly. If that alone is Brahma, then Brahman also should be experienced clearly by me. But that's not so. Ataha spashtatva aspashtatva bhyam tayoho bhedaha. Therefore, in as much as one namely Jiva is experienced clearly, and Brahma is not experienced clearly, at least from that standpoint, spashtatva aspashtatva bhyam. First of all, the bheda was pointed out because the different names are there. Secondly, bheda is pointed out because different places are there. Thirdly, bheda is pointed out because they experience the clarity and lack of clarity of experience. That Jiva is experienced clearly and Brahma is not experienced clearly. And so, spashtatva spashtabhyam tayoho bheda iti chet, therefore we say that Jiva and Brahma are different. Iti chet, if this is a question, no. Darpane pratibimbasya sphutatvevi bimbasya asphutatva asphutatvavat. Just as in our experience also we know that bimba and the pratibimba, meaning image and reflection, are one. Reflection really is not separate from image, in as much as reflection cannot have an existence apart from the image. So vyatirekena abhavat, other than image the reflection cannot exist, and then we say that the reflection is not separate from image. So we know that they are one. And still, when we look at the mirror, there is a very clear perception of the reflection, but there is no perception of the image. So, darpane pratibimbasya sphutatvevi, in darpana of the mirror, the reflection is very clearly perceived. Bimbasya asphutatvat, but the image is not clearly perceived in the mirror. Kalvila bhedena virudva dharma vyavastha uvattehe. So there is some kind of bheda there. We also accept the bheda. What kind of bheda? Kalpita bheda. The only difference is the Vedantins also respect the duality. It is not that when the Vedanta says that jiva brahmaivana paraha, that jiva is brahma and none other, it is not actually a disrespect or a condemnation of duality. Vedanta respects duality, in fact, respects it better than other people, because Vedanta takes duality for what it is. That's a real respect. To look upon it as less than what it is also is not respecting, and to look upon it as more than what it is also is not a respect. To look upon something for what it is respect. And so Vedantins accept the duality experience, but that is what? Kalpita bheda. That bheda of the duality is a product of kalpana, is not real. So kalpita bhedena viruddha dharma vyavastha avavattehe. Jiva dharma is what? That Jiva is very clearly experienced and Brahma is not clearly experienced. That in Jiva and Brahma appear to be possessed of contradictory or different kinds of attributes, and all of that is due to upadhi bheda and not due to the fact that they are really different. So whatever bheda we experience is all explainable when we appreciate that the bheda is kalpita and not real. So says Ratnava again, satya bhede yesham agraha tesham doshamaha. On the other hand, those people who insist that the bheda or the difference between Jiva and Brahma is real, tesham doshamaha. What is the dosha, the defect in their thinking? Is stated of Bhashyakara, yetu iti. Yetu nirbandham kurvante te vedantartham badhamanaha shreyodvaram sammik darshanam eva badhante kritakam anityam cha moksham kalpayante nyayena cha na sangachyante iti. Yetu, those however, in spite of all of this, nirbandhan kurvanti, that's all. For some reason or other, they just insist, that's all. But no, this is what we continue to believe, this is what we'll take. Nirbandhan kurvanti, they just have an agraha. Te vedantartham bhadhamanaha. Those who insist that I am jiva, regardless of what you say, it is my experience, and therefore that is all I will accept. I will refuse to accept anything else. Nirbandham kurvanti. They just insist. Te vedantartham bhadhamanaha. Those people who are actually negating what actually Vedanta is propounding, then all right, what does it matter? Suppose I don't accept what Vedanta says, so what? Shreyodvaram samyak darshanam eva vadhante. They deprive themselves of samyak darshanam. They deprive themselves of darshanam, the knowledge of reality as it is. Because they insist upon accepting the reality other than what it is. And that samyak darshanam, the knowledge of reality as it obtains, is Shreyodvaram. So that knowledge alone is a gateway to Shreyas or one's own well-being. And so by deliberately rejecting it, insisting upon that the duality to be real, one is actually depriving oneself of that very gateway to Shreyas or gateway to one's own well-being. Say Ratna Brahma, Suyam itivat tattvamasiti akaryakaranadravyasamanadhikaranyat atyanta abhedaha vedantartha. What is Vedantartha? What is it that Vedanta teaches? Darshana Vedanta atyanta abhedaha. Total oneness. So Soyam Devadatta, this is that Devadatta. So Devadatta obtaining now and Devadatta obtaining in some different conditions are absolutely one. No difference between Upadhika Veda. But Dravya Devadatta, Upadhika Veda is there. That time you went Devadatta with suit and boot and stuff like that. And now see a Devadatta in a beard and all sorts of stuff, you know. So Veda is there, Upadhi. But Dravya Devadatta, Dravya was that very reality of Devadatta is one alone. That is important. Similar Tattvamasiti, Akarya Karana Dravya. There is Dravya reality, which is what? Akarya Karana. Devoid of the ideas of cause and effect. So the reality that is devoid of the idea of cause and effect is Samanadhikaranya Tat and Tvam. Actually, they express Samanadhikaranyam, which is brought about, which is because they dravya the reality which is devoid of ideas of karya and karana. Otherwise you say Ishvara is karana, jiva is karya, Ishvara is karana upadhi, jiva is karya upadhi. So even the karya and karana, both of them are placed in the same adhikaranam. That way actually expressing or showing the reality that is devoid of the idea of karya karana. Atyanta abhedaha vedantartha. And so the meaning of Veda or the Vedanta has its vision in absolute oneness. Tad bodhaiva nishresa sadhanam, that is samyak darshanam. And that alone is shreyodvaram, that is nishresa sadhanam. That bodha, that knowledge of absolute oneness is the means of moksha. Tasya badaha niruktaha ityarthaha. It doesn't make sense. It is not right to deliberately deny that knowledge which is a means of your welfare, well-being. So what's the point in denying something that is a means of your well-being? Why do you deny a medicine which is going to cure your disease? Go and take it. Take this food, it's going to help you. No, I won't. You know, and things like that. And so the thing that is meant to be the means of one's own welfare, what's the point in denying that? No sensible person will do it also. If somebody denies, then we must see a sense in that also. Anyway, that's okay. But anyway, so tasya badha na yukta ityartha. And therefore, tasya badha, so tasya badha na yukta. To deny that, you know, it is not proper. Says Ratna Brahma on page 337, kincha bheda bheda vadinaha jnana karma bhyam kritakam moksham kalpayanti tatra anityatvam doshaha bheda bheda vadinaha. These those people accept bheda and abheda, all these, both are bheda bheda vadinaha. Ashvarathya, as out of only both of them are bheda bheda vadinaha, then difference is that Ashvarathya accept bheda and abheda obtaining together as karya karana. Our Vami accept Bheda in the samsara avastha and Abheda in the moksha avastha. Both are Bheda Bheda Vadina. In both of them will require you to do something to become liberated. You cannot be liberated as you are, you must do something. So jnana karma bhyam krutakam moksham kalpayante. They think that moksha is brought about by jnana and karma. One by jnana, other by karma. Tatra nityatvam dosha. And so there, that moksha which is a product of either jnana or karma is going to be impermanent. So anityatvam dosha. So krutakam anityam cha moksham kalpayante. They do also talk about moksha. But then moksha is something that is brought about by some effort, and that is going to be impermanent. Says Ratnava, yattu kritakam, abhi nityamidi, tachya yat kriya sadhyam tada nityamidi, nyaya bhajitam. So nyaya very clearly says, yat kritakam tada nityam. So that which is brought about by action is always going to be impermanent. Therefore, to insist that moksha is permanent, even though it is brought about by some upasana or whatever, is actually what? Nyaya bhajitam is something that is opposed to the nyaya or the reasoning also. Nyayanacha nasangachanta iti, and therefore it is not in keeping with the reasoning also, and the moksha that they are propounding is impermanent also, and by insisting upon the duality as real, they are denying for their own self the means of their own ultimate welfare. All of this is not proper. There is no need to have that kind of an agraha or insistence. Se yatnavaha asmakam tu anarthat dhumsasya jnana sadhyatvat. Nitya-mukta-atma-matrattvacca na-nitya-tva-dosha-iri-bhavaha. How are you, Vedantins? What kind of moksha do you have? So we say that moksha is a never-obtaining phenomenon. Moksha is never created, never attained. It is just brought to manifestation. Which is there, it is just realized, that's all. Asmākam-tu-anartha-dhunsasya-jnāna-sādhyatvāt. We say that what is unearth or bondage is purely a product of ignorance, and that is dispelled by knowledge. Nitya-mukta-atma-matrattva. Atma is ever nitya-mukta, ever liberated. Nitya-nivruttasya-nivruttihi, nitya-praptasya-praptihi. Mahatma is always saying, nitya-praptasya-praptihi. Attainment of that is ever attained. Nitya-nivruttasya-nivruttihi. The removal of that is ever removed. Bandhanam. Na nitya-tva-dosha, and therefore, it is only a matter of removal of obstacle and not bringing the moksha into existence, and therefore it is not impermanent. So nitya pradosha is not there. Tasmat maitreyi brahmanam pratyak brahmani samangitam iti siddham. And therefore this maitreyi brahmanam, the whole upadesha to maitreyi pratyak brahmani samangitam. So it is not upadesha of jivatma or bhokta atma. It is upadesha of param brahma, is what is established by this adhikaranam, this nyaya. So by this adhikaranam, this has been established here. Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Gacchate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Bhadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvara Guru Atmedi Murti Heda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.